Arteta?
Yeah, Klopp and Arteta. So the two of them are going hammer and tongs, with Klopp suggesting that Arteta was maybe pointing the finger at Sadio Mane going down. Well, this was the two of them. This was post-match, and this was Klopp first.
With the situation, Sadio just didn't touch the player. And then they go up and ask for a yellow card. And it happened against Sadio so often. It's like it's a part of a game plan. I don't have the idea what they thought in that moment. But it happened last year against Real Madrid, only to make a few moments. Sadio couldn't do anything anymore because the ref was for him. Wow. You make one more thing, you're off. For an offensive player, he's not a hard player. He's not a crazy tackler or whatever. Atletico here, we had to take him off at halftime because Atletico was a clear idea. Yeah, now we decrease their number as well. And for me, it was the same in that situation. That's why I said, I just ask, what do you want? Well, what do you want in that situation? Maybe we are now show yellow cards for no contact in the air. Then it would be a crazy game. So that's all.
He tried to defend his side and I'm trying to defend my side.
Are you all friends now?
Yeah, I'm completely fine. That stays on the pitch, that's it.
Did you shake hands afterwards?
Yes, I did, yeah.
All right, okay. Was there a tactic? Because Jürgen seemed to think that Mane was being targeted by players to try and get him booked.
No.
Yeah, I mean, Arteta saying there at the end, you know, that was out in the pitch and it's over now, but it was seen by millions. What's your take on that? Because many Liverpool fans, that was all they needed to be fired up and really give the team a push.
Well, it got them going because they'd got a bit flat. Arsenal did all right in the start of the game. Liverpool were a better team and would have won the game anyway, I think. But it was a little bit of a mistake from Arteta. I've got no problem with him being passionate and trying to defend his players. I mean, we were talking about it earlier. I'm not a big fan of managers being so animated on the line all the time. It becomes a bit samey. It's like, you know, calm down, we're all right. Stop panicking. It's screaming, shouting at everything. It was a nothing challenge. Arteta was passionate. He was trying to protect it or have a go at the ref about Mane's challenge. Klopp said something. They had a few words. No problem. The problem is that when you do it at Anfield, you get the fans going.
Yeah.
And when the fans get going, the players get going. And Liverpool's intensity went up by about 10%, and that was all that was needed. But yeah, they'd have won the game anyway. I mean, they didn't lose the game because of it. But I think he'll have learned something from it. The last thing you want to do at Anfield is get them fans behind.
But do you think it was a natural reaction or a contrived one?
Natural.
So then what can he learn from it? That's his. What does he do? Is he adjust the way he is because he's at Anfield?
No, just generally adjust the way you are.
Why?
Because it doesn't help.
But they're all doing it now.
Oh, that's all right.
So Klopp's, I'm not suggesting it's right or wrong. I'm saying that why does he need to adjust and Klopp can do what he does and Conte can do what he does and so on and so forth.
Because
why does Arteta need to do it?
Well, because he's managing Arsenal away at Anfield. So, if you manage Liverpool, who win most weeks and you're animated, you're all right because you know the players can back you up generally if you're being a bit animated and they'll go off you maybe. But
right.
Arsenal at the moment don't need that. They need him to just be a bit calmer on the sideline.
That's his character. That's what he feels, and that's the way he wants to manage.
Then he's going to.
So what you're suggesting is because Klopp, after two or three years of not winning anything with Liverpool, I suspect he probably had the same histrionics when they weren't winning, and he couldn't rely on them every single week.
Yeah, to a degree.
So why should Arteta, when he's at the beginning of his journey, sit there and do something different to what Klopp does?
Well, to be honest with you, I'd like them all to pipe it down a little bit because I don't like it.
You were just defending Conte a minute ago, saying how you enjoyed watching him managing Italy.
If you enjoy something, doesn't
Spain.
Mean it's right.
Well, what's wrong with it? Why do you want them to pipe down? I don't like them signalling planes down and making a big production out of it.
I just think you make it more difficult for yourself by doing those things because you get the referees against you a little bit more, and you get a reaction from the supporters. Mm.
Do the players see it, Danny? If you're on the pitch playing, do the players bother?
My experience of the players I played with, when your manager is becoming a bit of an idiot and too much histrionics, you kind of get embarrassed for him and think, you know what?
Yeah.
Chill out a bit.
Yeah.
And that's just the feeling I've always had from players. It's like, what is he doing? He's off again. Mm. And I think, I mean, Klopp in the past, when he ran on against, was it Everton in the middle of the pitch and stuff like that, it's a bit more, just a bit of respect. I saw Conte at the end.
But he hasn't got any.
Who?
Klopp.
I'm not saying he has.
So I think whether Arteta can back it up or not, I think you start as you mean to go on. Now, I do think he's a bit over the top, but by the same token, what are you going to let Klopp push around for? Klopp gets his view. He can do what he wants. He can wave planes down, but you can't.
I'm not suggesting he shouldn't have stuck up for himself, but you've got to pick your battles.
What amuses me, Simon, is the two of them looking to get at each other.
Yeah, yeah.
But there's never an intention to get at each other.
I think they're both wrong, and they both look like they regretted it after. Yeah. Because they're intelligent guys.
Yeah.
I don't think it helps anybody, them doing it.
Klopp didn't sound like he regretted it. Klopp sounded like he was doubling down on the reasons why he did it. Whereas Arteta's going...
if you see on, if you watch the game...
Okay, from the clips that I've heard, Klopp is explaining reasons why poor Sadio Mane has been picked out by three or four different sides, as if that's Arteta's problem. Arteta's basically suggesting that Arteta's watched the game against Real Madrid, watched the game against Atletico, and decided that actually what we're going to do is we're going to target Mane as well. Or maybe Mane leaves it about.
I don't think that's true. I don't think they did.
Well, that's, but I don't think he did either, but Klopp did. Mm. So Klopp's advancing that as his defence mechanism. He isn't going, it was handbags. It was, he was basically saying, this is the reason why.
Do you want to settle this outside? This is better than
we'll do it fantastically well.
I just think, look, as I said, Arteta's more than he's allowed to defend his
corner.
Well,
make your mind up then.
But I don't think it benefits his team, him being that way.
Okay.
I don't think it does. I don't think it that benefits your team.
That was going in the Klopp Arteta direction, I have to say. It was
that would be one-sided.
That
would, oh, my dear God, yes.
Jim White and Simon Jordan, Monday to Thursday morning, 10 till 1. On AM, on DAB, via the talkSPORT app, and on your smart speaker. talkSPORT.